What's up? Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm here with the look using the Anastasia Beverly Hills Shadow Couture eyeshadow palette. I believe it's called, Is it Shadow Couture? I don't even remember. It's the World Traveler palette. Yeah, that eyeshadow palette. And I'm using those three shades. And the first shade I'm packing all over my eyelid as a base. So for my cut crease, I'm taking the shade Morocco and just blending this out as much as possible because this is a dark shade. So you want to make sure while using a dark shade, you want to just create an outline first. And it looks kind of messy, I know. And then I like to blend it upwards. And then after that, I'll take the blending brush and then just reapply over and over until I get the consistency of the eyeshadow as precise and as much as I want it to be, if that makes sense. So in the next clip, you're gonna see me just blending that out with a blending brush, an eyeshadow blending brush by Ecco Tools, and then I'm going to be reapplying that base shade that I first applied all over my eyelid, just reapplying that, because as you put on eyeshadow you tend to lose the I'm going in with Morocco on the outer corner. Is this Morocco? The one that I used before was called Fudge, the brown shade in my cut crease. Wow, I am all over the place. But like I said, while using an eyeshadow, you want to make sure that you blend as much as possible because you tend to lose some of the color as you apply different shades. So you just want to reapply and reapply as much as possible. Sorry, that was really confusing. I'm like getting ahead of myself. So now I'm taking this shade right here and I'm putting that in the inner corner tear duct, thinking that my eyes were going to pop out more, but it kind of didn't. By the way, that mark in my inner tear duct is a beauty mark. I was born with it. Not a beauty mark, a birthmark. Sorry. So yeah, that's what that is. And now I'm just blending out the outer corner of my eyes. And now I'm going in with Maybelline's Ultra Black Liquid Eyeliner and just doing my normal wing eyeliner. And then from the inner tear duct, in like the next clip, I'm going to be using the Tarte Cosmetics Tardius Gel Eyeliner. I like to use that for the inner tear duct because it just... it's neater to use with the brush that it comes with and it's more precise. So yeah. So for mascara, as always, I'm taking Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara and applying this on my top lashes, and then later on I'll be applying that on my bottom lashes as well. Next step, which should be happening right now, I'm going to be taking the Urban Decay Naked Skin Concealer. I forgot which shade this is in. Not the lightest one, but like it's like a medium shade. And I'm just kind of applying it where I would normally highlight before I contour and just concealing under my eyes. And I like to bring the concealer into my nose just to give the illusion that my nose is a little bit slimmer. That makes sense. And I'm going to be applying that in like dabbing motions with my beauty blender. And I like to use the little tip part, the triangle part, to blend out my concealer under my eyes. And now I'm using the Laura Mercier translucent powder to set my concealer, and I'm going to be doing a technique called baking. I'm not going to blend that in yet. I'm just going to let that sit in place, and while that's sitting in place, I'm going to go into the Kat Von D contour kit and just do my contour. Then I'm going to go back where I applied the powder that I'm applying right now, and I'm just going to like sweep it off my face and just blend everything out. So right here, I look kind of silly, so I'm laughing at the camera. And yeah, so I'm just doing everything I just explained previously. So taking the Laura Mercier powder, translucent powder, I'm going to be cleaning up my contour to give myself that sharp, precise contour that I like. You could do this technique if you want to. It's not, you know, mandatory. And I'm using this Makeup Forever blush. I forgot the shade or the name of the blush, but it's by Makeup Forever. And now I'm going in back with that same eyeshadow palette and taking the black shade and just smoking out my waterline. But for some reason it looks navy blue on camera. I don't know why. And again, I'm going back in with Too Faced Better Than Sex Mascara and applying that on my bottom lashes. And I'm taking these lashes by Coco Lashes, these falsies. And they are in the name Risque. And they're very dramatic, which I like. For neutral eyes, for the most part, my eyes are neutral except for my waterline. So yeah, I'm only doing one lash on camera. It's kind of tricky. So yeah, and while that is drying, I'm going to be applying my Becca highlight in Moonstone, my favorite highlight. Well, not my favorite highlight, but the Becca highlights are popping. Like, you have to purchase those from Sephora. They're pricey, but they're worth it. They're so pigmented, and I just love it. Don't mind the eyelash glue. I mean, it's drying, guys. It's drying. So, yeah, I'm just highlighting, strobing. So now I'm just blending everything out a little bit, and I'm going in with MAC Cosmetics Cork Lip Pencil. I just showed everything at once. Slow down, girl. I am applying my lip pencil. And then I'm going in with MAC Cosmetics Honey Love Lipstick. And then I'm going to go in with Makeup Forever's Lip Gloss, which I got in this 500 points package by Makeup Forever. So I don't know the name, but it's just a sample. And we're done with a completed look. So here's the completed eye look. And yes, girl. So yeah, this is the final look. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Oh, also forgot to mention, I'm wearing NYX eyeliner on my waterline. Sorry. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Follow my Snapchat and Instagram. I'll put that in the description bar. And yeah, I'll see you in my next video. Bye.